Welcome. I want to thank you for viewing this video. This is the video on the wood stove Insertee. It's an idea I came up with a little over a year ago. Like a year and a half ago in the fall, I was not wanting to burn my wood stove 100%. It just wasn't cold enough to burn 100%. When I did, it was too hot. And just the coals build up because I dampened it down and it just wasn't burning good. So I got to thinking, well, maybe I can buy some. So I started looking around, checking up wood stove stores, and nobody said that they had anything of that nature. So I decided to make one, and I've done that. And I made a prototype and just by a manufacturer bolted together with some mango iron and stuff. And since that time, it's evolved into a much nicer package, actually. It's now evolved into this particular unit here. And as you can see, it's bulletproof. Okay, it's quarter-inch steel plate. It's welded to a base with the upright with a little kind of a stabilizing bar, I call it, up here, plus a handle for holding it up. As you can see, it weighs about 15 pounds, so it's not real light, but it's what you need inside that wood burner to hold it up. And I've used one now most of last winter and so far this winter, and it's worked very well. So I've moved to the next level. I've also went and entered for a patent on the particular item, and that's in the works now for over a year now. So now I'm going to try to start pushing a little bit, and it's a perfect time of the year coming up. What I found out was that in the fall, your milder winter days, spring, when you get the temperatures that drop into the 20s, then go up into 40s, 45, maybe 50 degrees, and you know it's going to cool off at night. So you hate to let the fire just go out. You have to try to burn it throughout the day efficiently. It just wasn't feasible with the whole wood box wide open. So I thought, well, can I make this thing where I can just use half of my wood stove during these periods? Where I can burn one half, I can stack the wood higher, because fire doesn't go very well left and right. It likes to go straight up. So if I can put additional wood in a vertical, it burns hotter, cutting down some of the emissions, yet the BTU output, because there's less fuel, is reduced. And it's worked out very well, I feel. So what you can see is I got one side burning right now. Because right now it was down in the back there, low 30, went down about 26 last night. So last night when I fired it up, kept going. I've got it going 24 hours. I burned both sides last night. It's just easy, just put wood on the other side. And ironic enough, just by laying wood on the other side, the empty side, the fire will jump over on its own, no starter necessary. So last night I burned both sides to take advantage of the extra output. This morning I left the left side burned down. As you can see, and I'll open the stove in a minute here, but the left side, it's going down to cold. And I mean, within a day, when I put new wood in there, those coals go to absolute ash. I've got a bucket over here, it's half full for the last 3 weeks, I think. It's all ash, literally ash, because it can burn down. I'm not piling wood on top of ash, and that builds up, and it can't burn the coals down, and I put more on. So it's worked out for ash maintenance as well, I feel. But on those colder days, burn both sides. If it's not real cold, you're up and down, the air, I just add a log to it. You can shift that partition there left or right. You can make it a little bit bigger to the left, a little bigger to the right, whichever you feel works for you, maybe depending on your size of your wood. I got it pretty much in the middle right now. I'll open up, you can see here. Yeah, it's gonna be pretty warm here, but right now the right side is definitely burning. I just put a log in not too long ago and it's burning. You can see the coals underneath it. And I'll just let that burn down, and I'm gonna close this door because it's extremely hot coming out of there right now at that one side. So I'm gonna close this back up. But yeah, so right now what it is it's great for these milder days, spring, fall. Last week, 2 weeks ago, we were into some 8-10 degree weather. I just pulled it out. I mean, all you do is, and you want to wear gloves, obviously. When it's sitting here, it's very hot. I allowed the fire to burn down pretty good and scrape some of the coals off the edge of it. Put a good pair of gloves, just reach in, pull this thing out. You can hold it by the handle here. And again, this weighs about 15 pounds. But putting it back in, you can scrape the cold oil on one side or do it on a cold stove. And again, you just want to slide it in, shift a little bit left, a little bit right, whatever you feel you need to size your real box. Do it, you know, it varies. But it's worked out very well. And if you burn a lot of wood, I'm sure you have the same problems I have, where you end up with coals building up. And with warmer days, you say, okay, I'm going to damp it down. Well, all it does is sit there and stew. It doesn't really burn. It just kind of stews, and the coals build up and never go away totally. And this way, I just burn one side. I got a flame burning. It definitely helps. I think with the creosote, keep built off because you got a flame. And that cold day last week, 2 weeks ago, I just took it out. As you can see, very easy to take it out. Utilize 100% of the wood box. So that's where it's at right now. I'm going to put a little sign up here in a minute. You can copy down in the note or the address where you can get a hold of me. My phone number is 724-961-6786. Ask for David. And also, I'm going to have a Gmail site you can go and send me an email if you'd like, and we can converse that way and talk about it. You could ask me questions on just how efficient it is and how it works, and we'll go from there. Right now, the price, I'm looking at a $50 price tag on it. Within my local area here, within reason, free delivery, and that's negotiable. Outside of that, we'll have to talk about how to work that one out. I've checked in some of that, and it's not cheap to send a 15-pound piece of steel. But anyway, here's the phone number and my email address. I'm going to jot that down there. If you want to contact me, give me a call or email me. I'll get back to you, and we'll get together and at least talk about it. I think it's a great idea. In my personal opinion, I use it consistently now. I just do, and I think it's worked out very well. So again, I want you to have a good day. We'll think spring, but in the meantime, for the next month and a half to 2 months, Insertee, the Woodstove Insertee, it's a pretty good fix for this upcoming time of the year, and then for the spring time now and fall next year. And I thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, definitely give me a call and drop me an email, and we'll talk about it. Have a good day. Thank you.
Take a load off, man. Take a load for you. Take a load.